Hi everyone, we are Group 16 from AB Products Engineering Company.
For thousands of years, people have gradually developed from the Paleolithic age to the present age of science and technology. Man has been exploring the world. Engineers are committed to finding an environmentally friendly and efficient way to produce the products we want.
So today, I'm gonna give you a brief introduction of our Aniline production process and some detailed design concepts. Aniline is an organic compound and widely used in drugs and explosive production industries. In general, it is produced commercially by catalytic hydrogenation of nitrobenzene, but this reaction is highly exothermic and nitrobenzene is toxic to the human being. However, we are determined to never give up and explore clean, powerful, and efficient production methods. Finally, we overcome this difficulty. We use ammonia and phenol, which are commonly seen in chemical industries, to produce aniline. This method gives almost no byproducts and hazardous gas emitted.
Our aniline plant is designed to produce 50,000 tons per year of aniline, accounting for 5% of North American aniline market. Ammonium bisulfate is produced as a co-product in our process. The phenol osmosis reaction requires a solid catalyst, and the reaction is taking place at a temperature of 375 degrees Celsius and 1655 kilopascal in vapor phase.
Here is our PFD. Ammonia and phenol enter the reactor after some pretreatment parts to produce aniline. As the feed molar ratio of ammonia and phenol is 6.4 to 1, the membranes are introduced to separate the unreacted ammonia from the product stream. We used to try separate them by using distillation column, but it doesn't work well. In order to increase the profit and make full use of unreacted ammonia, we designed a co-product line. Combine the ammonia with sulfuric acid together to produce ammonium bisulfate, which is commonly used as a fertilizer. It is an ionic reaction, so the conversion rate is high, and all the drying equipment like crystallizer, fluidized bed dryer are not expensive, which means our cost of co-product line is pretty low and we can make more money from them.
A hazard study was conducted to ensure the process safety. Main hazards were identified in the aspects of proper storage, disposal, and handling of various chemicals. Efficient methodologies of maintaining a safe operation were carefully considered, which covered all possible hazards presented on the plant. A typical 20-year forecast was used to assess the economic feasibility of this project. The process revenues were estimated by using production capacity of 51,000 metric tons of aniline product, along with the average market prices for all the feedstock, catalysts, and products that can be sold. For the economic aspect, Alberta taxation was accounted. Taxation figures along with the total capital investment were calculated to provide the best outlook on potential break-even point and the payout period. Economic analysis shows that the project is highly profitable with nearly $7.2 million USD net after-tax profit per year.
As engineers in UC, we hold common targets and a commitment to think disruptively and drive the world forward. The Earth is what we all have in common. Thanks for watching.